Welcome to Back to Basics. I'm Krupanidhi, a senior solution architect with AWS. In this episode, we're going to talk about chaos engineering with Fault Injection Simulator, a fully managed service for running fault injection experiments on AWS, which makes it easier for you to improve your application's performance, observability, and resilience. With Fault Injection Simulator, or FIS, you set up and run experiments that help you create the real-world conditions needed to uncover application issues that can be difficult to find otherwise. AWS FIS provides templates that generate disruptions and the controls and guardrails that you need to run experiments in your production environment. Before we dive in, let's look at some of the challenges with distributed systems. Distributed systems have multiple components located on different systems and vary greatly in implementation. As distributed systems grow in complexity, so does the difficulty in predicting failures. Failures of mission-critical distributed application can cause costly outages. Even simple distributed systems are complex. Let's take a look at the simple client-server communication. There are a lot of steps involved to complete a single round trip successfully. Client puts a message into the network delivers the message to the server, the server validates the message and updates its state if required. Server puts the reply onto the network. Network delivers the reply to the client. And client validates the reply and updates its state if required. There are so many permutations of failure that can happen in this simple distributed system. Now imagine all this over thousands and millions of requests. Traditional testing, like unit and functional tests, is required, but doesn't always address the complexity of a production environment. Running these tests in isolation only verify a known condition. What about the random errors we are not expecting? The configuration drifts, the network errors, the unknown conditions. How can we test for something which we don't know about? Luckily, there is a practice which helps with these kind of unknowns, and it is chaos engineering. Chaos engineering is the process of stressing an application by creating disruptive events, such as server outages, API throttling, etc., observing how the system responds and implementing improvements. We literally break things on purpose to build a more resilient system. Chaos engineering is not about injecting faults randomly without a purpose, but injecting faults in a controlled environment with well-defined experiments to build confidence in your application and tools to withstand failures. To do that, you have to follow a well-defined scientific method that will take you from understanding the steady state of the system you're dealing with to articulating a hypothesis, running an experiment, often using fault injection, verifying the results, and finally, learning from your experiments in order to improve the system. While chaos engineering is a great option to have in your toolbox, it's often hard to get started with. Hard because most of the time, you have to stitch different tools, scripts, and libraries together to cover the full spectrum of faults you can inject in a system. Compatibility of required libraries and agents for these open source tools may be limited. It is also difficult to ensure a safe environment in which to inject results. You want to be able to limit the extent of potential issues from an experiment, and without guardrails, an experiment can go sideways, affecting the rest of your environment. And finally, some failures are really hard to reproduce. It is important to realize that outages rarely happen because of a single failure. It usually happens because of a combination of small failures all happening at the same time or in a sequence. To address these concerns, we launched AWS Fault Injection Simulator. You can use AWS Fault Injection Simulator via the AWS console or the AWS CLI. The console is great for getting started and trying things out, while the AWS CLI lets you automate things with your CI/CD pipeline. AWS FIS integrates with IAM roles and policies, so you can be sure that only authorized parties can run experiments. You can also define more fine-grained controls, for example, what type of faults are authorized and on which resources. When you create your chaos experiment from the console, AWS FIS automatically creates a template for you, a template you can export and reuse later. We start with an experiment template, which will comprise of different fault injection actions, like generating a high CPU load on an EC2 instance. FIS actions also help you control the timeline and duration of the experiment. FIS performs the actions on the AWS resources that are specified as targets when you start the experiment. A target can be a specific resource, like an EC2 instance or RDS database in your AWS environment, or one or more resources that match a criteria you specify. You can monitor the experiment using AWS CloudWatch, and FIS can also be integrated with Amazon EventBridge, which allows you to integrate with your existing monitoring tools. Experiments, once started, automatically stop when all the actions are complete, or you can optionally configure to stop the experiment when an alarm or event is triggered. Once the experiment is complete, you can view the results of the experiment to identify any performance, observability, or resilience issues. You can use AWS FIS in periodic game day events by creating potential failure conditions and observing how effectively the team and systems respond. You can also integrate FIS into your continuous delivery pipeline. This will enable you to repeatedly test the impact of fault actions as part of your software delivery process. In this episode, we explored how you can run chaos engineering experiments easily using AWS Fault Injection Simulator. FIS provides you the flexibility and built-in safeguard mechanisms to run chaos experiments at scale. Check out the links below for more details. See you next time.